In today's video, I'm going to show you my four favorite build hacks in Bloxburg. Hey Glossettes, welcome back. How are you guys doing today? Tell me down below, as usual. Today is of course Tutorial Tuesday, and this one is a bit different. I'm going to be showing you four different tutorials instead of just one, and that's because I'm going to be showing you four of my favorite build hacks in Bloxburg that I use in my builds. You've probably seen them in my builds if you've watched my videos before, so we're just going to get straight into it. And the first build hack I'm going to show you is how to make your Bloxburg bouquets look like this and have a lot more flowers. For this hack, you'll need a basic shape cube, a carpet, so I just use a welcome mat, a vase of your choice, and then five flower bouquets. You'll also need advanced placing for this one, but what you want to do is place down your vase. It's a lot easier if you do this on the large or medium grid, because it's kind of the way you need to place the flowers. So I'd place it down on the large grid or the medium grid, and then the same with the basic shape. You want to pop this over the top of the vase, and then what you want to do is lower it down so you can see just about the top of the vase like that. Then what you want to do is place your carpet on the top, and then now you want to get your flowers. So what you want to do is, obviously we know the vase is directly under this, we want to place a flower right on top in the same spot, but we're going to rotate it each time so they're kind of like one facing each way, if that makes sense. So you just want to place them right in the middle in the same place. It's kind of hard sometimes, that's why I said do it on large or medium placement, but you may have to angle your camera just to get them all in the same spot. But it should look like this, so you place one facing each direction. And then what you want to do is delete the carpet and the basic shape, and then place the final flower in the actual vase so it pops out the top. And then of course I'm just gonna quickly add some color to my flowers, and this is what it looks like. So you have this very kind of full vase of flowers that looks a lot better than just placing one bouquet in there, and I think that's definitely my favorite hack in the game. But that is hack number one. Hack number two is a bit of a strange one, but I'm gonna show you how you can get bigger bowls to build with in build mode. So this is the only bowl we have in build mode, and it's pretty small, so if you're ever making stuff that needs a bigger bowl, like mixing bowls or something, this is kind of impossible to use. So I'm going to show you how you can get this bigger one here. And for this, we actually need to go out of build mode. And as you can see here, I have a fridge placed down, which is pretty much all you need. So what you want to do is click on the fridge and click take ingredients, and then get the garden salad. And then you want to take this and you just want to make the garden salad quickly. I'm pretty sure that you don't need to be a higher cooking level. I think you do unlock the garden salad at level one, but I'm not 100% sure. And once you've made the salad, what you want to do is place it down and take all of the portions out of it. So just take all of the salad out like this. And once you've done that, you just want to get rid of the portions, so just get rid of the tray. And what you're left with is this empty salad bowl. We're going to hop back into build mode now. And if I move this little bowl, as you can see, the bowl that we've just got is a lot bigger than the build mode bowl. So yeah, pretty much what you can do is you can just use a salad bowl. It is dirty because it's had salad in it, but I was told you can like wash it and then still use it. I'm not 100% sure though, but yeah, you can apparently wash it. But if you're making something like a mixing bowl and you're putting stuff in this bowl with like basic shapes, it'll obviously cover it up, which is what I usually do. But that is how to get a bigger bowl in build mode. Kind of a weird hack, but I use this quite a lot. The next hack is how to do these super cute stone details on the corners of your kind of house builds, which I think make it look so detailed and fancy. I do this on a lot of my houses. Now, all you need for this is to go into structural pieces and go into this section here, the wooden plank, and you want to get the vertical wooden plank. Now, of course, you do need advanced placing for this one as well, I think. I'm not 100% sure, but what you want to do is go to the corner of one of your builds. I usually start at the top, and what you want to do is place a brick kind of this big. So you just want to like drag it along from the corner, and then what you want to do for the second bit is do it a bit smaller underneath. Make sure you leave a little gap in between both of them, and then underneath again you want to do the same thing, but you want to match the size of the first one. Underneath again you want to do it slightly smaller. So what you do is you basically alternate the sizes, and you just want to place it all the way down the wall, making sure you place it right on the corner each time. And there we have it. That is pretty much how you do it, but I'm also going to do it around this corner as well. Like that. And then what you want to do is of course color it. So I'm just going to color it a bit of a darker stone compared to the wall, like this. And that is how you add a super cute little stone feature on the side of your builds. Now, as you can see, it is 3D as well, so it probably like sticks out, and it just looks so cute and realistic, and I absolutely love doing this hack. So that is hack number three. And then we have hack number four, where I'm going to show you how to add these cute little details to basically any objects. As you can see, I added these onto the basic table. So if you look at this table, it doesn't have the details. detail. But over here it does, and it's just, it's a really easy way to add little details. You can do this on bookshelves, you can do this on like walls. I recently did this on some of my theater kind of counters and stuff to add some little details, and I'm going to show you how. So what you need for this is you need this bookend item from decorations, and then you need a square basic shape of your choice. I've placed three down just to kind of show you the difference. So this one's obviously a solid color, and then these ones are the transparent ones. This is what I usually use for little build hacks because obviously it's see-through, so if it's sticking out anywhere then you can't really see it, but they are more expensive, so it's up to you which one you use. Just keep in mind that this will be placed underneath the bookend, so you might be able to see it for certain hacks, hence why it's kind of better to do it like a transparent one. But anyways, yeah, what you want to do is take your basic shape of choice. For the sake of this video, I'm going to use this one just so you can see what I'm doing better. But then what you want to do is resize it to be the smallest possible size, like this, and then you want to grab your bookend and place this on top of the basic shape cube. Now you do need the transform tool for this and the advanced placing, I'm pretty sure, so these are kind of more complicated hacks. What you want to do is color your bookend, so I'm going to color it wood to match the table, and then also color the basic shape if you have like the solid one. If it's transparent it isn't as important, but for the sake of this video I'm not going to color it just so you can see it easier. And then what I'm going to do is copy and paste another one of these, so we have two for each side of the table. And then next, to put this into place and add the detail, you want to select the transform tool and then click on the basic shape underneath, and now as you can see it lets you move around the bookend like with the transform tool. So how I added them onto the table is I flipped them upside down like this, and then I just lowered it into place. So whatever you're adding detail to, you just want to kind of lower it down there like this, and as you can see this is what it looks like. So it just adds a super cute detail, and then of course we're going to do it to the other side, and there we go, we now have some added details to this table. So if you really like this table but you don't like the lack of detail, you can add it yourself basically. But yeah, it's a super fun hack. It is really good on bookshelves as well. I'll show you that quickly. So if you get, we're going to get this traditional bookshelf, and this bookshelf obviously looks a bit fancy but not really, it's not too extravagant. Hang on, let me color this wood. What you can do is you can grab the bookends on a basic shape and you can add the detail on yourself. So what I usually do is place it like on the top bit like this, kind of right at the front, just add a bit of detail like that. There we go. So we just add that at the top, and as you can see it adds a really cute detail to the top of the bookshelf and just makes it look a bit more fancy. But that's all my build hacks. That's my four favorite build hacks that I use all the time. I think the flowers are definitely my favorite just because they're really cute. But that is all for today's Tutorial Tuesday, and as usual, let me know anything down below that you want to see next Tutorial Tuesday. But that is all for today. A massive thank you to all my channel members. Thank you so much for joining the channel, and I love you all, and I'll see you all later. I love you all so much, Glossettes. XOXO, Glossy Girl.